have always loved Loki. Although I don't have any outfits like this. I found out about Loki when I was much younger. And I drew him even though I hadn't watched any of the Marvel movies. Anyway, I ended up eventually watching the Marvel movies and doing more artwork, but then I forgot about them. I mean, honestly, how long am I supposed to focus on one thing? I mean, I'm super into it, and two weeks later, it's something else. And there were more important things to draw anyway. But then, in the summer of 2021, Marvel gave Loki his very own series. And I was in love. I tuned in for every episode. My cats are literally named Mobius and Sylvie. And then the season ended and I forgot about it again. But the important thing is, Marvel came up with a bunch of new stuff recently and reminded me how much I love it. So I decided I'd do a little art to give a little tribute to everyone's favorite godly trickster Jotun cat. Given how ethereal the whole TVA thing and the entire show is, I knew I wanted to do something with the sacred timeline and planets. Kind of like Loki is floating alone in space after Sylvie breaks the timeline. I also knew, color-wise, that I wanted to do stuff with oranges and purples and pinks. And I wasn't sure why until I remembered that that's most of the TVA colors. I also had the design idea that I wanted to make it look like he was turning into a Jotun. But I called the markings on his face, I called them Galra markings, and I'm not sure why. For this drawing, I drew him in the outfit he wears through most of the series, minus the first episode. I love this outfit so much because it's so different than every other outfit he's ever worn, and I just find it so great. Shading a project like this that has no lines is always so fun because the lines come out through the shading. You also get to make up some details you maybe missed or forgot about or added in the sketch and didn't like. Here's where I add the blue skin on the right side of his face. Have to happen. I'm such a nice person. Why does it do that to me? Another thing I knew from the very start was that I kind of wanted this picture to look sad and lonely because I feel like a lot of the time he is sad and lonely. Also, when I stepped back and looked at it, I realized the eyes were way too small and the nose was way too curved. And here is where I add the sacred timeline and all its little realities and planets. Which ended up looking like trick cereal in the end, for some reason.